you to remember.
A love song. Hey, what's up, everyone? This is the one and only Mark Francis back once again. Intro review is back. Part 14 is here. Folks, it's been a long, long time to keep you all. Folks, congratulations to the Detroit Legend for winning another Stanley Cup. Special congratulations to Nicklas Mikkelsen, one of the best in the game. Now, here is a guy that, you know, he's played in the NHL for at least 15, 16, 17 years. You know, he's the first ever European defenseman or European player to ever captain a team and lead them to the Stanley Cup. You know what? Steve Yzerman left some good leadership back in Detroit. I think every single player on the team on the Detroit Red Wings are good leaders. Look at Zetterberg, you look at Datsyuk, Dan Cleary. I mean, the first Newfoundlander to win the Stanley Cup, that's pretty amazing. You know, I'm totally shocked, but that is pretty amazing. It's pretty amazing, dude. You got to tip your hat to this team. Such great consistency. It starts from management, goes right down to the players. We have Stevie Y, Kenny Holland, Scotty Bowman, all up in management. And you have good coaching staff and Mike Babcock. You know, I mean, anything's possible. And this team has shown it time and again that they're one of the best teams in the world. And, you know, sometimes they don't get the credit that's due because they are one of the best teams in the world, folks. No doubt about it. You know, the Detroit Red Wings are a team that, you know, you can't put your thumb on it. You can't even put your finger on it. They're just one of the best in the world. And it's an honor to be able to watch this team play. You know, they play the game the way it's supposed to be played. They play the game with such fast pace, good of everything. Good defense, good goaltending, good goaltending, and good defense and good goal scoring. You know, they have a good balance, a four-line attack. You know, by bringing back Darren McCarty, man. Darren McCarty, I think he was one of the best players in the playoffs this year because he's the Pittsburgh Penguins in the Stanley Cup Final. His intensity on the fourth line, you know, made it easier for the star players to do their job out there. You know, they know they had a Darren McCarty on their team to go up against a big guy like a George Laroque. You know, it was an awesome series. Sidney Crosby played awesome that series. So did Marian Hossa. You know, the reports are up. You know, today's Canada Day. Happy Canada Day, everybody. Forgot to say in this NHL review part 14 that Hossa might be signing somewhere on the East Coast. What I'm hearing, it looks like the Ottawa Senators might be a player, and I'm hearing that the LA Kings, I think that's where he'll sign. He wants $9 million a year, it looks like, and I think he'll be the big breadwinner when it's all said and done. There's Matt Sundin. Don't be surprised if Matt Sundin ends up in Montreal. You know, it's a good chance he might end up there or the Detroit Red Wings. But if he does end up in Detroit, it would be no surprise to me. He wants to win a Stanley Cup. And don't forget, look at that team. So many Swedes on that team. You got Lidstrom, Zetterberg. I mean, come on. You got so many Swedes, you know. It's a talented, talented group with such talented, talented players. And when you think about it, you know, the Detroit Red Wings, they just know how to add and subtract from their team. You know, a couple surprises were to me was when the Toronto Maple Leafs bought out Darcy Tucker out of his contract. And then when they bought out Andrew Raycroft and they got rid of Kyle Webber. But the one thing I think Vancouver Canucks have done is when they went and claimed Kyle Webber off waivers from the Toronto Maple Leafs. I think this is a great move for the Vancouver Canucks. They got himself a playmaking center. One year he had 90 points. In junior, he was an unbelievable talent, a consistent player. He's played in the World Juniors. He's done it all. You know, Kyle Wellwood, just if he could just stay healthy, that's the only thing I can say. If he could just stay healthy, you know, this guy could really be a dominant force for years to come. He's just a young guy still. He's only like 24 years old. He's still a guy that can get the job done, no doubt about it. And I know a few other players that are really kicking, well, Ward's been kicking tires from some of the sources I've been, you know, checking out, like TSN, Sportsnet, Eklund, you know, a few of my sources. You know, looks like Brian Campbell. There's rumors that he might go to Ottawa, but don't be surprised if the Buffalo Sabres, out of nowhere today, sign him. I think they're gonna sign him. I just feel that they missed Brian Campbell, and I feel that, You know, if they're going to throw the money at Brian Campbell, I don't even think it will be about money. I think just because Brian Campbell loves Buffalo, and I think he'll sign there. I really thought he would have re-signed in San Jose, but, you know, that's what happens sometimes. Sometimes you don't get to re-sign the team that, you know, the team that you had an impact on at the trade deadline, you know. But, you know, sometimes it never does really work out sometimes. So, you know, in the end, you have to be positive. You have to be, you know, you got to know that it's not going to be easy, but, you know, you got to be, you know, with it. You know, you got to be down with the program. And I really feel that Brian Campbell is down with the program. I really feel that he, you know, he could help a team out here. And I think the team he's going to help out is the team he played most of his career with, is the Buffalo Sabres. And with some other big names out there like Todd Bertuzzi, you know, you're talking the names of Peter Forsberg, Joe Sakic. I mean, don't be surprised if the New York Rangers throw some money at a guy named Joe Sakic. I know. I'm not saying he's going to sign there, but you never know. Sometimes money does talk. And I wouldn't be surprised if Wade Redden and Joe Sakic are Rangers by Thursday, because you just never know. In the NHL, anything's possible. But one thing Colorado Avalanche did right was they re-signed John Michael Lyles, especially Adam Foote. I mean, Adam Foote is the reason why those goalies are good again. So, you know, especially Theodore. I mean, Theodore has no choice to go back to Colorado. He's not going to make the top dollar he's going to want to make on the open market. I mean, the most money I think he makes is maybe $4 million. I don't think there's any team's going to really take a chance on him because, you know, Theodore is a shaky type of player. You know, I know he's regaining some of that confidence, but, you know, it's because of the good defense that he had in Colorado. You know, another player I really, really hope gets an opportunity probably to back up a goalie in the NHL is Dan Klutschke. You know, Dan Klutschke's had some serious, serious injuries. You know, he got bought out of his huge contract. But I really think if someone could give him a chance, I mean, anything's possible. I think Dan Klutschke is going to be a guy out there that's going to make a difference next season in the NHL. So, folks, for the NHL review, this is the one and only Mark Spencer. And, you know, sometimes, folks, you always want to be part of history. Happy Canada Day. This is what it's all about. I can't believe I'm still doing this. This is going to be awesome. July 1st, the 8th of Friday. That's the signing we did. That's the fun we did. We'll see you guys next time. Come back and do our reviews probably Friday and talk about all the signings. So, folks, y'all have a good Canada Day. From USA, next week, I guess, July 4th, July, to USA. And a happy birthday to everybody in the world that's born on this day today. Remember, folks, in the game. Keep playing the game, folks. And you know what? Summer might be a video game. The plan. Take care, everyone. Keep the one and only Mark Spencer. Congratulations to Spain. Just like I said, they won. So long, everyone. Take care. Bye-bye. Can it come?